well.
Just a little bit?
Listen, he plays a lot of characters really, really well. I'm not sure if he's going to pull out the Luigi, but I know he was messing with K. Rool.
Doesn't he also have the Bowser Jr.?
I believe so.
I know he played that in 4.
Oh, yeah. So he's going to bring out the Ganon. I mean, I'm interested to see how these guys are going to do it. But we also know Mr. E. I mean, Mr. E is well loved. This also, go check out Mr. E's stream. He is a streamer. I'm interested to see how this is going to go, though, starting on Battlefield.
And you, like, the only player we haven't talked about left is Faker here. And, like, you can't count on Faker. Like, this is a Rutgers team, Faker and Grandpa J. And this is a team that will.
I think graduated Rutgers team.
They're Rutgers boys at heart. And, like, the thing is, like, ooh, they will mess you up if you doubt them even for a second. Faker is a hell of a good Lucina. Super underrated, in my opinion.
Oh, my God, these parries, though. That's the thing. Once you realize this timing with Ganon and you're not afraid, that's the big thing. Do not be afraid. You can parry a lot of Ganon's hits. And Ribs doing a beautiful job of just taking Ganon off
stage. The only thing I'm going to suggest is once Grandpa J can finally, like, get some stage control and get a little more control over his character, like, he needs to help Faker as much as possible. Because we're already seeing this. They're dividing the stage in half, and Mr. E is solely just crossing up Faker. And if anyone, again, this is another thing where if you think about the character Lucina, you think Mr. E.
Right.
He knows this character inside and out, like the back of his hand. And so now, like, when you have a less experienced player like Faker, like, he's just going to take advantage of that. Eric's just going to know everything he needs to do to just counteract it. And right now, Grandpa J is already sitting at one stock. Ribs and E sitting pretty at 3.
I mean, it is Ganon versus, I mean, we could take out, like, the player aside. At what point do we start looking at, like, just the characters again? I mean, it's Ganon versus Lucina and Ness, both with amazing offstage capabilities.
And it's basically been Ganon and Ness this entire time. Right. And Ganon's just going to constantly get juggled. And Ribs, wow!
I told you this guy's crazy. Ribs is great. I remember Ribs in the beginning of Smash 4 was insane, but Grandpastor J gonna get the dash in.
Good job by E there, saving Ribs. Ribs was in a bad edge guard situation, and now it was just Faker, but Grandpastor J decides to take the stock. I'm not even, again, 2v1 never fun, but I'm at this point,
I like that 2v1 never fun.
At this point, though, I wonder if that decision was wise because we've seen Faker have the more success in this matchup. Ribs has literally not let Grandpastor J breathe.
This is over.
And now it's going to be over soon. And, like, I hate to say that.
Oh, you hate to see
but
it.
But it's over.
That was nice.
Oh, sh nice.
That was nice.
Like, I just don't agree. I personally don't agree with that stock share because I think Faker was doing.
I disagree with the entire team. Get off that Ganon. Justin plays Luigi. Luigi is one of those characters, I think, in this game and also in this region that whenever you see, like, a Luigi player in your bracket, you're like, oh.
Yeah, no, you literally, like, you stop everything you're doing, you're like,
what? Oh, God. And you're like, oh, I know I'm going to get grabs, but I forget the proper DI. And here comes that Luigi.
When you play a Luigi and it's like 3, 2, 1, go, and you see you're that plunger, you want to start crying.
You just start screaming. You start, like, smash DIing everywhere. We're going to stick with the same team on Ribs and Mr. E's side, which I don't disagree with. I don't think Mr. E plays with anybody else, does he?
Marth.
That doesn't count.
It's a character.
All right,
Echo Fighter.
PS2, but I'm interested to see how we're going to work more together here from Red Team.
It's going to be a lot better in terms for Faker and Grandpa J because this is already taking out a lot of juggling situations for Ribs. So it's going to be interesting to see. Grandpa J just has to play this smart a little bit. Help out Faker when he can because, again, he was dominating Faker.
Oh, yeah.
Like, really didn't
let him. I think both players on Blue Team kind of did that rip apart. Like, all right, we'll just take both of these players off the stage and just do the 1v1s, and it worked. It definitely worked. I mean, we saw Ribs versus Grandpastor J was not pretty.
Nah, not at all. That was not fun for Ganon whatsoever. And that's just Ganon Ness. And I think Luigi Ness could be a little better for him. However, he just has to play it correctly. We have to see, again, that team synergy coming out. These Rutgers players play each other all the time. They know what they need to do with each other. They know how to handle this. However,
they know how to make an upset, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, Rutgers is, like, it's Rutgers, NJIT, and, like, Rowan, like, are, like, the three big, like, New Jersey schools, and they know what they need to do to get stuff done.
Right. I also think right now, though, I see a lot of Mr. E and Faker kind of 1v1-ing. Like, why not switch it up? I mean, you realize that both players are kind of struggling. Why not have Faker fight fight Ribs instead of Grandpaster Jay?
Because I think it's becoming the fact that Mr. E and Ribs are kind of pressuring it that way
right.
to make it so that they can't do that. Yeah. Like, because I think I'm pretty sure, like, Grandmaster Jay and Faker aren't stupid people. Like, they're not bad players. They know, I believe they're thinking exactly that. I think it's just a matter of Mr. E is the more experienced, more knowledgeable player.
Right.
And with along
I mean,
with someone like
Ribs. Stocks are even right now.
Yeah. But I think it's that matter of Eric and Ribs go, okay, they're going to try and separate us. They're going to want to try and switch up each other. I just have to, and Mr. E's like, I just have to stay on Faker. I know this matchup. The Lucina matchup is pretty common. So, Eric's like, let me handle this. Help me pressure them to get me this matchup.
I'm sure E has played that Lucina Ditto 100 times.
Oh, it's insanely common for him.
Ooh, okay. Oh, look at this mix from Ribs!
But the misfire killing Grandpaster Jay in the end there. Those are the kind of misfires you don't want.
Right. But that's kind of like the risk that you take whenever you're trying to throw it out. I mean, it could be super beneficial or it could mess you up.
You could get a funny haha or a funny no-no.
I mean, 4 stocks to 3, not terrible right now, but it's just that the 1v1 is so dominant right now that it's hard for these players to play doubles.
Right now, Grandmaster Jay offstage again. Ribs just doing a good job, not able to, got too pressured. And here comes the stock share again.
He can't
but
take a stock at 150, he's dead.
I hope you liked playing the game, Faker.
Ooh, okay, so I want to see what they got for a team combo here.
He gets a forehead.
There you go.
That's the team combo. Right. Take a forehead.
Oh. Listen, you know what? If it worked, it worked. Oh, but see, this is what I mean.
I like how Eric just stood there. He's like, take it.
Oh my god, you're sick!
Oh.
You're sick. That was so sick.
Dude, Grandpaster Jay is good.
Right. Like, this is what I mean. It should have been the Luigi all along.
Like, again, like that Ganon was a completely different player.
Oops. You imagine that was Ribs' last stock.
Right? I'm so done. I'm
imagine
so
that was Ribs' last stock and that's how it went down.
this has been my commentary block. I'm done.
Imagine if that was Ribs' last stock and then Grandpaster Jay brought it back. I mean, granted, he didn't, but still. Wow.
Oh my god. Mr. Ian Ribs taking that 2-0.
That's Smash.
That's
Smash Bros.
It was so delayed.